First, do you know my name?
I know.
I think you don't know.
Miss Amel.
Oh,
but
okay.
I don't know the full name.
Oh, okay. Okay, everyone, I think we have to introduce ourselves first. And because this is the first time of our meeting, right? My name is Rezeki Amelia. You can call me Miss Amel. Okay? Hi, nice to meet you, everyone. For us to pray first. Noval, can you please stand here and lead your friend to pray together?
Okay. Okay, friends, before we study, let us pray together. Pray start. Finish.
Thank you, Noval. Okay, everyone, I'm going to check your presence here. Red.
Present, Miss.
Nova?
Present.
Lucia?
Present.
Fatifa?
Present.
Putri?
Here, Miss.
Ari?
Present, Miss.
And Sakina?
Present, Miss.
Okay. Okay, everyone, I think all of you is here. It's great today. Now, everyone, please prepare your book and your pen. I want to see your book on table. Please prepare it. Okay, sudah?
Yes,
Miss. Yes. So that's okay. Yeah. Good job, everyone. Thank you. Now, do you know what kind of materials do we study today? Ada yang tahu kira-kira kita hari ini belajar apa?
No, Miss.
No?
No.
Are you sure about that?
Yes,
of course. Okay. Now, first, you can see right on the screen. I want all of you to write down these things we're going to learn about this one. And don't forget to write down my name and the date, okay? Silahkan ditulis dulu di bukunya masing-masing. Okay, sudah? Sudah?
Sudah, Miss.
Nah, gitu kan, Miss, jadi tahu. Okay, everyone. I have a question for you, I think, and you have to answer me. Ari, what are you doing?
Right now, I'm writing your material.
Okay, and what is Sakina's doing? Do you know that?
Sakina is the model explanation.
Oh, okay. Good job. And Nure, what are you doing?
I'm listening to your lecture.
Okay. And what is Noval doing? What is Noval doing?
No, follow listening your lecture.
Okay, that's right. How about you, Noval? What are you doing?
I'm listening to your lecture.
The same like Nure?
Yes.
Okay, and what is Putri doing?
It's the same, listening to your lecture.
Okay, Lucia, what are you doing?
I guess it on my chair.
Okay, and what is Fatifa's doing?
He's listening to you.
Okay, good job. So everyone, I think all of you is known about it. I ask you, Miss bertanya ke kalian tentang apa yang dilakukan teman kalian kan? Yang berarti, apa yang sedang dilakukan sekarang? Sekarang, what are you doing? Apa yang sedang kamu lakukan? Berarti hal yang kamu lakukan sekarang. And then, what is your friend doing? Yang dilakukan temanmu sekarang. So, based on this question, we're going to learn about, ada yang tahu kira-kira grammar kita yang tentang aktivitas sekarang?
Present.
Continuous, that's right. Now we're going to learn about present continuous. That's right. Good job, everyone. Now, do you know what is present continuous, Putri?
It is a tense that is used to describe the situation right now.
Okay, the situation right now. Okay, good job. It's a very short explanation and it's very clear. And that's why I want to explain about what is present continuous. Jadi, present continuous adalah present dalam grammar yang digunakan untuk menjelaskan aktivitas sekarang. Bener banget. Berarti kalau misalnya lampau nggak bisa dong, Miss? Iya, nggak bisa dong, karena yang hari ini, ya kan? So, I have two points here. What is the use of? First one is to express activity that is happening at the moment. Benar kata Putri tadi. Aktivitas yang dilakukan sekarang, at the moment. To express activity that shows change. Menunjukkan. bisa berubah kan, mungkin lagi menulis lagi gitu. Jadi yang sekarang ini dia bisa berubah nantinya. So, it express activity that shows change or temporary action. Jadi aktivitas yang temporer sementara. Jadi dua poin ini adalah yang menunjukkan apa sih present continuous itu. Oke, silakan ditulis di bukunya. Dua poin tadi ya. Oke. And then sudah? We finish?
Finish.
Finish. Okay, finish. Good job everyone. Now, on the grammar, we know that there is auxiliary. You know what is auxiliary? Ada yang tahu apa? Ayo, apa? Ayo, masih ingat gak kemarin? Auxiliary itu apa?
I think I forget, miss.
Okay, you're fine. How about you, Ari? Do you know what is auxiliary?
Kata bantu, miss.
Kata? Bantu. Contohnya?
Seperti to be.
To be?
Is.
Oke, okay. Oke, okay, benar. Oke, okay, didengerin apa ya tadi ya? Apa tadi coba?
Kata bantu.
Kata bantu, benar banget. Auxiliary adalah kata bantu yang membantu kata kerja. Dan kata bantu itu ada banyak. Ada to be, ada primary, and ada modal. Nanti kita belajar lagi ya selanjutnya ya. Untuk sekarang ini, auxiliary yang digunakan dalam present continuous adalah auxiliary to
be.
Apa aja sih, Miss, auxiliary to be? Ada yang inget gak?
Am,
is, are, pelampau,
were,
was, ada lagi?
Has,
are you sure?
Had.
Ayo, masih inget gak?
Be,
being, and, been. Nah, lupa ya kira ya. Am, is, are, was, were, and then being. Itu auxiliary to be. Tapi untuk present continuous kita hanya menggunakan 3 auxiliary aja. Yang pertama ada
am.
Yang kedua
are.
Yang ketiga
is.
Good job. What is the difference between this aux? Ada yang tahu? Sakinah, ada yang tahu? Kalau am
beda subjeknya.
Beda subjeknya, benar. Benar ya, ada contohnya sini ya. M itu digunakan untuk
I.
Kalau A?
You, maybe.
Kalau is?
She, he, it.
Oke, kalau singkatnya itu I, you, Dewi, she, he, it. Oke, M itu special karena dia cuma digunakan untuk I. Jadi dia nggak bisa kalau she, M nggak ada, he, M nggak ada, they, M itu nggak ada. Oke, ingat ya, special. Kalau R dia digunakan untuk subjek yang
jamak
artinya apa?
Banyak.
Apa aja contohnya?
They
and
we.
Kenapa ada you, miss? Padahal kan dia cuma satu aja, miss. Kalau you, dia spesial kayak I. Jadi cuma you, kamu kan satu orang. Tapi dia menggunakan yang I, dia spesial ya, ingatnya. Sedangkan kalau they cuma we karena dia
banyak.
Terus kalau yang is, dia digunakan untuk kata pengganti orang tuh
dia.
Apa aja?
She, he, it.
She itu apa?
Dia berapa? Dia berganti.
Kalau it?
Benda
atau?
Binatang.
Nah, itu bisa semuanya tuh. Gitu ya jadinya ya. Oke, benar banget nih. M is our atau auxiliary to be. Dan jangan lupa dikombinasikan dengan kata kerja bentuk
ing.
Kayak mana contohnya? Kalau read jadinya?
Reading.
Kalau sleep jadinya?
Sleeping.
Kalau eat jadinya?
Eating.
Kalau drink jadinya?
Drinking.
Nah, gitu ya. Jadi kata kerja pertama tinggal ditambahin ing. Oke, jangan lupa ini adalah auxiliary yang kita gunakan ketika menggunakan present continuous. Pakai to be dan pakai kata kerja bentuk
ing.
Oke, silakan ditulis dulu di bukunya. Selanjutnya kita akan membahas lagi tentang contoh struktur teks kalimat. Are you finished?
Yes.
Okay, good job. Now, like I have said to you, we're going to learn about the formula. So, on the present continuous dalam sebuah kalimat, Miss Beth bilang kalau ada yang namanya positif, negatif, dan
interrogatif.
Ini udah sangat-sangat basic banget ya, ada positif, negatif, sama interrogatif. Tapi gimana, Miss, kalau misalnya dia dibentukannya pakai present continuous? Yang Miss bilang tadi, harus ada auxiliary dan Verb-ing. Kalau misalnya nih kita pakai simple present, aku makan ayam. Nopal.
I'm eating chicken.
Kalau pakai simple present biasa.
I eat chicken.
Oke, okay. I eat chicken. Subject, verb one, object. Kalau diubah ke present continuous, Adri, gimana? Subject plus auxiliary to be plus working plus subject. Aku makan ayam.
I am eating chicken.
Yes, that's right. Jadi yang I eat chicken kalau mau jadi present continuous diubah eat-nya ditambahin dulu tadi auxiliary-nya karena tadi subjeknya I. Misalnya ya, misalnya ya, I am drinking vitamin C now. Kalau simple present-nya apa?
I drink vitamin C.
Itu kalau simple present ya.
Yeah.
Tapi kalau present continuous ditambahin ada am di sini. Ada am. Am itu sebagai apa?
Auxiliary.
I am drinking vitamin C. Vitamin C. Karena subjeknya I, kali I apa auxiliary-nya?
M.
Makanya di sini
M.
M terus ditambahin drinking. Jadinya kalau drink jadi
drinking.
Makanya di sini jadi drinking ya. Baru objek. Contoh lagi semisalnya kami tidur di kasur misalnya. Kami apa bahasa Inggrisnya?
We.
Kalau we auxiliary-nya pakai apa tadi? Yang banyak
are.
Tambahin are. Tidur?
Sleep.
Berubah jadi verbing?
Sleeping.
Di kasur?
In bed.
On the bed.
Di atas kasur ya, bukan di dalam kasur. Makanya pakai on. Oke, kami tidur di kasur. Kalau present continuous itu berarti adalah we are
sleeping on the bed.
Kayak gitu ya, paham?
Paham.
Oke, okay, good job. Ada contoh lainnya nih. I am drinking vitamin C now. She is. Kenapa pakai is? Ya, benar. Cooking dinner tonight. Oke, okay, itu contohnya. Terus kalau negatifnya gimana, Mem? Miss. Negatifnya gampang, tinggal ditambahin not di antara auxiliary dengan verb ing-nya. Contohnya tadi, misalnya yang ini nih, kami tidur di kasur. Berarti kalau negatifnya apa?
Tonight.
Okay, good job. Jadi gitu ya. Tinggal mengubah auxiliary-nya ke depan aja gitu. Sama kayak are you eating sugar right now? And is Tina going home? Jadi auxiliary-nya di awal. Cara bedanya mudah banget. Kalau dia ada auxiliary di awal, berarti dia bentuknya pertanyaan dan perlu ditambahin tanda
tanya.
Oke, okay. Now you can write down on your book about this formula. Is there any question?
So far no, man.
Miss. Oke, okay, ada. Are you finished?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, good job. Now we're moving. I have a picture here and you have to guess. Okay, ada gambar. Miss mau kalian menebak kira-kira mereka lagi ngapain sih? Yang pertama, what am I doing? What is she doing? And what is she doing? Coba. Siapa ya kira-kira ya? Ari deh. Ari, kira-kira bisa jawab pertanyaan ini enggak? What am I doing?
I am sleeping.
I am
sleeping.
Oke, okay, kita tulis sini ya. I am sleeping. Karena dia lagi tidur ya katanya. Terus kalau Lucia yang nomor 2, gambar nomor 2 dia lagi. What is he doing?
He is eating a pizza.
Okay. He is eating pizza. Number 3, coba Latifah. What is she doing?
She is reading.
She is reading? Apa yang dibaca?
Book.
Okay, she is reading book. Okay, Miss mau nanya sama Ari, kenapa dia pakai M?
Karena subjeknya I.
Okay, karena subjeknya I. Terus di gambar dia lagi tidur,
jadinya yeah.
Sleeping. Okay, kalau siang kenapa dia pakai is tadi?
He is katanya, karena subjeknya he.
Okay, karena subjeknya he. Terus dia lagi makan tadi, warnanya apa?
It menjadi eating.
Oke, okay, good job. Sekarang kalau Latifah, kenapa dia pakai is?
Karena subjeknya she.
Oke, okay. Terus dia baca buku verb 1 nya apa? Verb 1 dari
read.
Read, oke, okay. Dia read ya. Tapi karena ada, karena di present continuous ada auxiliary, jadi hati
jadi.
Yes, that's right. Good job everyone, all of you is correct. I am sleeping, he is eating, and then she is reading a book. Good job, you have answered correctly. Okay, karena sudah bisa, Miss mau kasih tugas sekarang. Ada pertanyaan gak kira-kira terakhir nih?
Gak
ada. Beneran. Are you sure about that?
Yes.
Beneran nih. Coba Miss secara random ya, mau tanya nih. Kalau subjeknya dia we pakainya apa Lucia?
Are.
Kalau dia subjeknya it pakai apa Putri?
Is.
Oke. Okay. Kalau dia verb-ing dari makan apa? Verb-ing dari makan bahasa Inggrisnya.
Eat.
Verb-ing-nya?
Eating.
Oke. Okay. Kalau verb-ing dari kata menulis Nuret?
Reading.
Menulis.
Writing
is. Writing, oke. Okay. Kalau bentuk verb-ing-nya dari menonton, Ari.
Watching.
What?
Watching.
Watching, oke. Okay. Bisa ya berarti ya semuanya ya.
Oke. Okay.
Sudah siap? Siapkan dulu bukunya. Jangan ada catatannya ya di buku tugas kalau bisa. Oke. Okay. Let's identify it. Which one is present continuous? Tadi Miss sudah bilang kan perbedaannya present continuous sama simple present. Dia harus menggunakan auxiliary. Terus harus diikuti dengan bentuk kata kerja
verb.
Oke, okay, kalau yang pertama kita bahas dulu ya nomor 1 dulu deh. Setelahnya baru kalian kerjakan. Nomor 1, my family go to the beach. Is it present continuous or simple present?
Simple present.
Who wants to give the reason why? Oke, okay, Sakina?
Karena kata kerjanya menggunakan kata kerja pertama, sedangkan untuk yang present continuous itu dia pakai verb ing.
Oke, okay, good job. That's right. Karena kalau my family go to the beach, dia pakai bentuk verb 1 go. Berarti kalau bentuk verb ing-nya apa?
Going.
Berarti kalau bentuk simple present continuous dari nomor 1 apa? Ada yang bisa ngasih jawaban? Bentuk simple present dari nomor 1. Ada yang mau katakan? Ayo. Katakan atau misalnya setuju? Ayo. Oke, okay,
Nure. My family are going to the beach.
Oke. Okay. My family
are Going.
Going? My family-nya itu dia menunjukkan jamak atau singular? Plural atau singular?
Singular.
Ayo. Kalau Nora bilang tadi my family are going to the beach. Oke. Jadi kalau untuk my family, dia walaupun keluarga ada banyak, tapi dia digambarkan sebagai subjek yang
singular.
Berarti kalau singular jadinya
is.
Oke, sekali lagi mungkin jadinya
my family is going to the beach.
My family is going to the beach. Oke, bisa ya? Jadi jawabannya ya. Now I want all of you to give, is it present continuous or simple present? And then if it is simple present, you have to include the simple the present continuous. Example, kayak tadi Safina misalnya, dia bilang nomor 1 itu adalah simple present karena bentuk simple present continuous seperti ini. Bisa ya? Silakan kerjakan dari nomor 2 dan 10 di bukunya masing-masing ya. Oke. Silakan dikerjakan. Are you finish?
Belum.
Okay, I think because the time is limited, I want this work to be homework. Okay.
Alright, Miss.
Jadi tugasnya ini yang belum selesai. Novel udah nomor berapa?
Nomor 5.
Okay, masih ada 6-10 ya. Karena waktunya sudah habis, I think everyone it is enough for our class today. Please do it on in your home. Silakan dikerjakan di rumah. Minggu depan kita bahas sama-sama. Bisa?
Bisa.
Oke, ada pertanyaan?
Nggak.
Sebelum kita tutup?
Nggak ada, Miss.
Beneran? Ya udah, karena nggak ada pertanyaan, bisa bertanya. Novel, silakan berikan kesimpulan.
Jadi untuk hari ini kita telah belajar tentang present continuous. Dalam present continuous terdapat auxiliary verb yang membantu kata kerjanya.
Contohnya
seperti I am sleeping. I am merupakan auxiliary dari verb sleeping.
Auxiliary-nya apa aja sih? M is R. Terus ada lagi?
Baru saya tahu.
Thank you, Rafael. Ari, kata kerja yang digunakan simple dalam present continuous tadi bentuk apa?
Dalam bentuk kata-kata pertama ditambah ing.
Berarti bentuknya verb?
Verb.
Terus tadi fungsinya dari present continuous apa, Putri?
Untuk menjelaskan situasi yang terjadi saat ini.
Good job. Yang terakhir, kalau bentuknya dia subjeknya plural, pakainya apa? Nure?
Yes, Miss.
Plural?
Are.
Kalau singular?
Yes.
Kalau saya?
I am.
Good job. Berarti paham semuanya ya?
Paham.
Gak ada pertanyaan ya?
Gak ada.
Good job. Now everyone, I think it's enough for our class today. Before we close our class today, let's pray together. Ada yang memimpin? Nure, silakan maju ke depan.
Before we close our listen today, let's pray together. Finish.
Okay. Thank you, Nure. Okay, everyone, please prepare and get in your book and your pen. And that's all for me. Thank you. I'm sorry if there's a misunderstanding word. And see you next week. Bye-bye.
See you.
Jangan lupa ya dikerjain ya.
Yeah.